Good Lord, didn't anybody here subscribe? Thank you.
There will be members of this crew who will not want to serve with Ensign Laren, sir.
They will have to learn to live with it.
I intend to demand the highest level of performance from her.
I would expect nothing less. Won't be for long, Will. Come. Yes, Ensign Laren, please sit down.
Ensign Rowe, sir.
I beg your pardon.
The Bajoran custom has the family name first, the individual's name second. I am properly addressed as Ensign Rowe.
I'm sorry, I didn't know.
No, there's no reason you should. It's an old custom. Most Bajora these days accept the distortion of their names in order to assimilate. I do not.
I wish to be candid with you, Ensign.
Please.
I'm fully aware of your Starfleet record, of your problems on other ships, and the incident at Garon 2 that led to your court-martial. And I'm concerned about your presence on this delicate mission.
I don't want to be here any more than you want me to be here, sir.
Then why did you take this assignment?
If I may be equally candid, it's better than prison.
Better than prison? There are officers who wait years to serve on this ship.
Being called back into Starfleet was not my idea.
Nor ours.
Nevertheless, we will all be serving together. Commander Riker and I have expectations of...
Captain, I know the routine. You don't have to worry about me. We're stuck with each other. So let's just get this over with as quickly as possible and go our own separate ways, okay?
Dismissed. Captain's log supplemental. We're approaching the Valo system on the outskirts of Cardassian territory, where many Bajorans have resettled.
There are dozens of Bajoran camps on the three Class M planets. I suggest we start on Valo 3, where an ad hoc leader named Jazz Holtza lives. The Federation has had several dealings with him.
I met Holtza at a symposium a few years ago.
What can you tell us about him, Doctor?
I found him to be a very concerned leader and a good spokesman for his people. And a terrific dancer. No, really, I'm serious. At a reception afterwards.
At least this man has genuine experience in diplomacy.
And that's a big advantage on this mission. Very well, Mr. Data, will you contact Horsa, arrange a meeting?
Sir.
Ensign Rowe, you're familiar with the star system, you'll take the con. Is there a problem, Ensign?
You're wasting your time. Holtza is nobody. He's the token Bajoran that respectable people invite to symposiums and diplomatic soirees. But he has no real influence among my people.
Ensign, whom do you suggest we speak to?
Don't you understand? These are desperate people ready to martyr themselves. They don't want to talk.
Well, this ship is prepared to defend itself if necessary.
Oh, it will be. Don't fool yourself. This mission will end in bloodshed.
Well, let's hope that you're mistaken, Ensign. But can you point us at the right individual, as Mr. Data suggested?
I would go to the camp on the southern continent of Valo 2. Find a man named Keeve Falor. He has no diplomatic experience, and he won't ask you to dance.
I love beans, diggity doo.